So you probably don't have problems playing video games or scrolling to social media. I bet you could do both of these activities at the same time for 2 hours straight without losing concentration. But what about studying for 2 hours or spending an hour to build your side business? I bet that could be very unappealing and complicated. Even though you know that study and exercise and building a business or something productive will bring you long-term benefits, but you still prefer playing video games and scrolling to social media and watching TV. But it's very obvious that these activities require less effort, while studying and exercising or starting a business requires more of you to apply yourself. But there are people out there that have no problem studying, exercising, or working on a side project. So this brings up the question, why are some people more motivated to tackle difficult things? And is there a way we can make difficult things more easier? So in order to answer this question, we need to look at the brain neurotransmitter, which is called dopamine. Dopamine is often considered a pleasure molecule, but in reality, that's not quite what it does. It makes us desire things, and that desire is what motivates us to get up and do things. So we can use this example, someone who's a drug addict. He knows what he's doing is not good for him, but all he wants is to get more of that drug. Getting high or using cocaine and heroin releases an unnatural amount of dopamine, which makes you crave the drug even more. But you also have to take in consideration that nearly everything releases some amount of dopamine, even drinking water when you're thirsty does. But the highest dopamine release happens is when you get randomly rewarded. An example of this would be playing the slot machines at the casino. Even if you've only been losing money until that point, you eventually expect to get a reward, and you just don't know when it could happen. So in today's digital society, we flooded our brains with unnaturally high amounts of dopamine on a daily basis, even if you don't know it. Some examples of high dopamine behaviors include scrolling through social media, playing video games, watching internet pornography, and etc. We anticipate some sort of reward with each one of those behaviors. So that's why we're constantly checking our phones, because we expect to see some sort of text message or other notifications, because we know that eventually we're going to receive it. So you're probably thinking to yourself, so what? It's not like it's doing me any harm. But you may be wrong. Our bodies have this biological system called homeostasis, which means that our body likes to keep internal and physical chemical conditions at balanced levels. So whenever an imbalance occurs, our bodies adapt to it. Let me give you an example. When it's cold outside, our body's temperatures fall. As a result, we start to shiver to generate heat and warm our bodies. However, when it's hot outside, our body temperatures rises, and we start sweating to lose some of that heat. Essentially, our body is looking to maintain a temperature of 98 degrees Fahrenheit. But there is another way homeostasis manifests itself, and that is through tolerance. An example of this would be someone who rarely drinks alcohol will get drunk a lot quicker. But for someone who drinks on a regular basis will have to drink more alcohol. That's because our body has developed a tolerance for it. So basically, it will take more and more alcohol to make them drunk, because they have become less sensitive to its effect. And it's not much difference with dopamine. Your body tries to maintain homeostasis, so it downregulates your dopamine receptors. Essentially, your brain gets used to having high level of dopamine, and those levels become your new normal. Thus, you develop a dopamine tolerance. This could be a huge problem, because the things that don't give you as much dopamine don't interest you in any longer, and it's much more difficult to motivate yourself to do them. They start to feel boring and less fun. That's because they don't release the same amount of dopamine compared to the ones that release high amounts. That's why we prefer playing video games or browsing the internet instead of studying or working on our business. Video games makes us feel good and comfortable. That's because they release a lot of dopamine. But exercising and studying, they release a lower amount. So this is one of the reasons why drug addicts who try to quit have a hard time going back to normal. Their dopamine levels get so high that their normal life isn't able to match it. So they start to lose motivation on doing anything. But it's not just drug addicts. It's people who are addicted to video games, pornography, and scrolling through social media have experienced the same thing. Once their dopamine tolerance gets too high, They can't seem to find any interest on any behavior that have low dopamine. So this brings up the question, is there anything we can do to prevent this? The answer is you need to perform a dopamine detox. By now, you probably have an idea what dopamine detox is. So let's take a look at it. So what you're going to do is you're going to set aside a day where you avoid all highly stimulated activities. You are going to stop flooding your brain with high amounts of dopamine, and you're going to give your dopamine receptors a chance to recover. But if you're suffering a drug addiction, then I suggest you seek professional help. So back to the detox. So for one full day, you will try to have as little fun as possible. Meaning you won't be able to use the internet or any technologies like your phone or computer. Also, you're not allowed to listen to any music. You're not allowed to pleasure yourself or eat any junk food. Basically, you're going to remove all sources of external pleasure for that entire day. And you're going to embrace boredom. And you heard that right, embrace boredom. But the things that you're allowed to do will be going for a walk, meditate, reflect on your life and goals, and write your thoughts on a journal, on a piece of paper without using your computer or phone. So you're probably asking yourself, why would this even work? So think of it this way. Let's say you've been eating every single meal at the best restaurant in town. So as a result, those fancy meals start to become your new normal. If someone offered you a bowl of plain rice, you would probably refuse it. That's because it probably wouldn't taste the same as the fancy meals you're used to. But suddenly, if you were stranded on an island, then that bowl of rice wouldn't look so bad after all. It's pretty much what dopamine detox does. It starves you from all the pleasure you usually get, and in turn, it makes all of those less satisfying things more desirable. To make it more simple, dopamine detox works because you become so bored that boring stuff actually becomes fun. So what you're gonna do is you're going to pick one day of the week where you're gonna refrain yourself from all the highly dopamine behaviors. For whatever behavior it might be, whether scrolling through social media, eating junk food, playing video games, watching internet pornography, whatever. And from now on, every single week for one whole day, you're going to avoid that activity. You can still do other things, but the behaviors you pick are off limits. Yes, you will feel slightly bored, but that's the point. You're doing this because you need to let your dopamine receptors recover. And boredom is going to propel you to do other things that day. Things you will put off because you don't bring the same amount as dopamine. And because you're bored, it will be a lot easier to do them. So this is why we should connect dopamine to the things that will benefit you in the long term. Whether it be in exercising, reading a book, cleaning your apartment, things that will benefit you. I do think that making difficult things a lot easier is possible. So let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Have you tried this before? Did it work for you? Please feel free to share my content to anybody who you think it will help them out. Also feel free to like and subscribe. I appreciate you guys watching all the way to the end. And I'll catch you guys later.